The Man with the Yin Yang Eyes, Season 2, Episode 18. Too surprised when Harris' hand grabbed his leg, Big D screamed in fear. We both thought that Harris was dead. Unexpectedly, he wasn't dead yet. Harris is still alive but barely alive. He mutters a few words in his mouth. Big D listens attentively and says that he seems to be saying something related to the underworld. Hearing this, I am really sad for Harris, only because of too much use of witchcraft to have the results like today. I bent down near Harris, wanting to say the last few words to him. I told him that he has filled with evil spirits himself, because he secretly practiced unholy spells. After entering the body, it was a drop of water that overflowed the cup, leading to being attacked by his own unholy magic. Harris whispered that only because he was too afraid to die, he did so, because he himself knew the crimes he had committed. When he died, he would be banished to hell to suffer, because of that fear of death. But he did everything he could to learn about the art of immortality. His whole life, he and my master cultivated the righteous path, but when he got old, he went against that principle and secretly carried out the evil way, the purpose of which was to redeem himself. The result of today has been warned by my master long ago, but he just listened and ignored it. At this moment, Harris only has one last wish, that I can save him so that he can die more peacefully. More than anyone, Big D was the one who showed the most anger, because over the years, Harris had betrayed his trust in him. Besides my teacher, Harris was someone Big D respected very much. Before Big D's reproaches, Harris didn't know what to say, only shed tears of regret. As if unable to hold back, Big D continued to scold Harris. It turns out that I was the one who helped you do wrong. The documents you asked me to search for you turned out not to be. It is scripture, but a book that teaches unholy ways. I was next to see Big D so angry. I spoke up to remind him to calm down. The important thing is to ask Harris about the whereabouts of the exorcist Wong and the silver-haired assassin. After listening to me, Big D immediately regained his composure and asked Harris about the exorcist's whereabouts. At this point, Harris could only whisper that he was also through a middleman named Mabu, who was a transnational timber trafficker who connected him with the exorcist Wong and hired him. They might be back in Thailand by now. Suddenly Harris reached out to me as if to say something else, but he had stopped breathing. Big D immediately asked me if I could perform the ritual for him, but I couldn't do it. I explained that there were too many demons surrounding him right now, and there was no effect. Gregory, this time we have to go to Thailand, but we have to find the middleman named Mabu. After hearing the information from Harris, Big D immediately decided to go to Thailand to find the exorcist Wong, but to know the exact location. He had to find Mabu first. The two quickly took a taxi to the headquarters of the boss Mabu. I'm so blind, I've known Mabu and Harris for so many years, but I don't know anything about their shady activities. They're trying to hide it from you. I say that to comfort Big D, but in my opinion, in terms of people, Big D is still very pathetic. It's just that I'm too naive and trusting. After listening to my consolation, looking at my posture, Big D also guessed my thoughts. He got angry, and I only sighed, didn't say anything more. When I arrived at the headquarters of Mabu, I only saw a big guy standing guard at the door. Big D told me to wait for him outside, and he will go in to check the situation, and then he would come out shortly after. It seems that the big guy has met Big D many times. So when he saw him approaching, he didn't take any precautions. Only saw that Big D had just come in less than 5 minutes and came back. His clothes were messed up, the guard and I were surprised, not understanding what happened. As soon as I got out, Big D immediately approached me and whispered. I saw some blood on his hand. "Hey Gregory, are you running fast?" I was suddenly asked a question that had nothing to do with the situation at hand, so I froze. Before I could understand what was going on, I saw a group of people behind Big D. I leaned over to see clearly. Only seeing that it was the boss Mabu and his gang members, blood was still seeping from his neck. As soon as he appeared, he shouted to arrest Big D immediately. "If you want to live, run fast." As soon as I finished speaking, I saw Big D running away. I dimly understood. This damn fat guy must have beat up the boss when he entered the building. When I saw the big guys behind the boss, I didn't understand anything, but I didn't dare to stay. Even though I started to run after Big D, I ran faster than him. I ran across Big D while asking that he got the information yet. He tells me he already get the information of the exorcist Wong, but because he wanted to teach that Mabu guy lesson for daring to deceive him over the years. Both of us ran for our lives. Behind us were dozens of thugs chasing close. Now I want to stop and punch this damn fat guy, but I don't dare to do it. It's okay to ask about the whereabouts of the exorcist Wong, but what's the point of poking fun at the boss to make us suffer like this? We chased after our ears, but in the end, the Mabu's gang lost track. Now they are very bewildered and angry, not understanding where we have disappeared. Even though they couldn't see us, they definitely wouldn't spare us, and they continued to chase the path we had just run. I should have planned to hide a little longer to be safe, but it was really unbearable. Originally the smell of garbage I could stand. I just can't stand that the damn fat guy farted at this moment. Hiding here is really unbearable. Right now, I just want to punch him a few times to relieve my anger. After getting rid of those people, I suggested to Big D that before going to Thailand, I should stop by the hospital to see how Miss Valentine's is. Hearing that, Big D immediately asked me, "Didn't you already have it? Are you in love with that beautiful policeman?" Somehow this fat guy's question smelled of gunpowder. "Don't talk nonsense. I just see her as a friend. Isn't she in this mess to help us?" I don't know why I'm embarrassed now, even blushing. Seeing my attitude, Big D immediately guessed that I had feelings for Valentine. He warned me not to flirt with his goddess. At this point, I didn't even hold back anymore. I also told Big D that if he mentioned Valentine again, we were no longer brother. At the hospital at this time, Ms. Valentine's condition is still not improving. Outside, many policemen were guarding, and for a while, Big D and I didn't know how to get inside. At this moment, Big D immediately thought of a way. When the two policemen were sitting and yawning, two female nurses came over. They said that they needed to go inside to check on the situation of the policewoman lying inside. When they saw the two female nurses coming, the two police officers were startled. Seeing that, Big D immediately said, "Does anyone want to take me out tonight?" Looking at their faces now, I think of the faces of people who have just seen ghosts for the first time. It turns out that this is the game that Big D plays. For my part, when I pretend to be a girl, it's not beautiful, but it's not too bad, and Big D is really a disaster. But just now, the two policemen were like seeing the devil. Inside the hospital room, Valentine was still in a coma. It seemed that the poison caused by the magical worm had not subsided, despite the doctor's efforts. At this point, I can clearly see the insect's movements. Looking at Valentine's arm at this time is extremely scary. I need some time to process this. You go out and keep an eye on me. Hearing that, Big D immediately went to the door to guard me while I was doing my job. But unfortunately, as soon as they got to the door, Big D encountered two policemen. Perhaps they saw that the two nurses had problems, so they went to check. They didn't expect us to be discovered so quickly. Now two policemen are trying to enter the room. They are worried for a reason, because we are two wanted people. After biting the tip of my finger, I used my blood to draw a charm on Miss Valentine's arm. At this moment, I only see Big D using his bulky body to block the door, and his mouth is constantly urging me to hurry. After I finished the spell, the blood charm in the female policewoman's hand took effect. Miss Valentine's arm is no longer purple and black, but this only works to slow the release of the toxin. It doesn't cure it, but this is the best I can do for the time being. Run out the window quickly. I can't keep them anymore. I turned around and saw Big D running in panic. As soon as we left, Miss Valentine regained consciousness and wished us a safe trip. While I was doing my thing, I was probably whispering that I would go to Thailand to find medicine to rescue her. At that time, the beauty woke up and heard. Seeing that, I was very happy. I said that I would definitely bring the antidote. Big D could only raise his hand to greet his goddess, and then the two quickly rushed towards the window. Or you can jump alone, let them catch me. This height is sure to jump to death. I didn't expect this fat guy to be afraid of heights. I must also admit that telling them to jump from here is like telling them to commit suicide for people afraid of heights. But now the two policemen were very close. It seemed that just reaching out to catch us. There was no other way to run. I had to push Big D down first while I rushed after. There was a small eave below, so we both took advantage of it to reduce the force of falling, only suffering for Big D. Because his body was too big, his action was a bit less flexible, so the result was not as good. Finally, the two of us got out safely from the hospital. Ahead of us now is a journey to distant Thailand. After much deliberation, the two of us decided to go to Thailand by ship, and of course, with two wanted people like us, we could only go smuggled. In life, I really can't say anything. Just a few days ago, I had a warm blanket and a soft mattress, eating and drinking, but now I have this problem. When it was up, Big D couldn't help but exclaim and complain. For two wanted people like us right now, this trip is very important. If it doesn't get the desired results, I don't know what bad things will happen. Seeing Big D like that, I could only speak up to comfort him. Suddenly, the person sitting next to Big D, for some reason, screamed out loud. Looking over there, we saw a very horrible scene. Out of nowhere appeared a lot of cockroaches, and even more strange, they were attacking the people present. Big D immediately stepped on the cockroaches that were constantly crawling towards us, but doing so only makes the situation worse. The cockroaches crawled out more and more and even took off to fly away. Big D and I realized that this was a manifestation of witchcraft. There must be evil spirits hiding in this deck. Looking in the cockroaches' movement direction, I saw a woman lying in front of us. The cockroaches came from the woman lying on the floor. That woman has signs of being possessed by a demon. Not only that, but this demon is also very strong. Can you solve it? At first glance, I discovered the cause. Big D, stand next to me, worriedly asked if I could do anything at this time. Cockroaches deliberately attacked the people around. Everyone panicked and didn't know how to handle it, only jumping on wooden crates in the deck to avoid them. Gregory, take this. When he saw the situation in front of him, Big D immediately gave me what he said was an exorcism treasure made by him. I looked closely and saw that there was a pen containing cinnabar or mercury sulfide. Immediately I took the pen in Big D's hand and drew a circle of protection for those around me. As I expected, the cockroaches are created by the devil. When the circle is drawn, the cockroaches stay away, because demons are very afraid of cinnabar. At the intersection of the circle, I carefully draw a spell to increase the protection. Suddenly Big D tapped me on the shoulder and said that there was also an exorcist on the other side of the deck. I turned to look in the direction Big D was pointing and saw a guy using salt to form a circle to protect everyone. This is also quite effective. Looking at the way he did it, I realized that this is the Western way of exorcism. Suddenly everyone heard a growl, the sound coming from the woman I was talking about earlier. At the same time, she also squirmed to sit up. A demon has possessed this woman, her eyes widen, looking extremely scary. Her neck is twisted to look at everyone, accompanied by a monstrous growl. But that is not the end. Her whole body now seems to be lifted off the ground, looking extremely scary. Both I and Big D frowned. A demon must have possessed this woman. Based on her extremely scary appearance at this time, we can confirm that the demon is not controlling her very strongly. She jumped to her feet, accompanied by the sound of her joints creaking. With a continuous growl from her mouth, lightning fast, she rushed towards where I was standing. Just as Big D was about to tell me to step up to subdue the rioting demon, we both heard a strange sound, and curiously we turned to see what it was. When I looked over, I saw a foreign man holding a cross in front of him, holding a Bible in his hand, and began to mutter exorcism verses. Seeing that, we both froze because we had never seen this kind of exorcism before. It turns out this man exorcises Western style. It is effective indeed. The demon controlling the other woman showed great pain and was quickly knocked out of the woman.